what is unique and distinctive about this particular meeting is, first of all, its size. There has, to the best of my knowledge, never been a meeting to do with sexual diversity of this a number of people, of this wide number of different people backgrounds that they come from, both cultural, but also we have people who are not Orthodox who are observers from the Anglican and the Catholic traditions. And we have people who are of a wide variety of opinions.
What's distinctive about this meeting is, actually, on one level, simply the number of people we brought together. We've got some, I think, 40 or 50 people all together, all respecting each other, all prepared to have an open, frank discussion, happy to disagree with each other and not taking it personally. To be able to have a discussion like that is really remarkably rare and a treasure.
So there have been other meetings that have started addressing the issues of sexual minorities and gender identity within Orthodox Christianity. And for the most part, they have not resolved or come to any conclusive resolution for these issues or even what the issues are. And so I think it's very much an ongoing conversation, and the more voices we can include, ecumenical partners we can consult, different perspectives we can listen to and understand, will really help us develop a perspective that is accurate theologically, responds in a way that shows we've actually listened to and encountered human perspectives around us for the people with whom these issues really touch their lives, which is increasingly everyone.
Well, what I found unique about this particular meeting is the variety of people who are engaged. We have everyone from conservative clerics to secular philosophers to activists in the LGBT movement. And I think it's a wonderful conversation to get such different groups together and let them listen to one another. And I'm learning a lot so far, and I hope to learn more.
I believe that the biggest value we can gain is actually just dialogue. Right now, I don't think we're likely to see the Orthodox Church make big pronouncements, big changes in its approach. In fact, I would say the Orthodox Church doesn't make many pronouncements anyway. But bringing people together to discuss all sides of an issue, that dialogue needs to begin and needs to be continued over and over again. So this, I think, is a really great start to that sort of dialogue.
While there have been differences of opinions, there have been moments of intense conversation, but respectful conversation, I also noticed that there were people talking at lunch and going to liturgy together and really trying hard to relate to one another in ways that, I guess, as Christians, we're called to relate. And that's very, very promising, because that shows that beyond simply the internet and conversations that happen there that can be very demonizing, you know, when you meet people face to face, I mean, real listening can occur and a real challenge can occur. And I think that's been unique, I think, but I don't think necessarily surprising.